This 22-room mansion on Awixa Avenue in Bayshore was built in 1904 by Elwood Mildeberger. It was originally called Oaklewood. Today it remains standing as a private residence that has housed many families throughout the years. In 2000, the home's current owner, Joe Weiss, was shown the home by a real estate agent.
We were kind of looking for a project, something that I could do as a hobby and fix up. And we came to see the house, and on the drive to the house, he just kept repeating one thing. It's very large. You have to understand, it's very large. By the sixth time he said it, I knew we were coming to a very large house. So we took on the project and we bought the house in 2000, and we worked on it for almost 14 months before we were able to move in. So we stayed in our home in Oakdale, and then we moved in 14 months later, and we just kept going, you know, trying to go into the rooms and make them look like they might have.
Weiss's restoration work and historical research became a passion, and he's gained a deeper appreciation for chronicling and sharing the home's history.
Over the years, we've had the family, all the families come to visit, from the Mildebergers, who were here from 1904 through 43, some of their family, to the Koch family, to the who were here from 63 to 83, and the Carr family, who was here from 43 to 63. But it seems like every 20 or 30 years, a new family comes here, takes over the house, and does something else special.
The most dramatic of these changes began in 1963 when the Koch family purchased the house and property. Joseph Koch was a builder who completely renovated the outside of the home into a Tudor style and renamed it Awixa Castle.
The original house had all the shake shingles. My father is the one who designed it into this castle effect because he always wanted a castle. He even tried to put a moat in, but the furthest he could do was that bridge. He took off all the shake shingles. He took all the bathrooms apart. Everything went flying out the windows. It was a mass production. He created the terrace that was added on. He added that on. He created the trophy room, which was add on for up and down, of which now they use as a gym and as a theater room. The foyer where we're standing at this point, he put this on also. And this was they call it the rattan room, because he had all that rattan furniture around and everything, the wicker, as my daughter puts it. So he did most of he did a lot of work here. He put a lot of money into this place. We had a lot of fun. A Christmas tree was in the hallway here. We had to move the chandelier for it to go up. We used to all get together to decorate it. We'd have a couple drinks, we'd have food and that, and we'd have a good time and carry on. To the point my father got a little tight sometimes. But we had a great time here. We had kids had go-karts out there, bicycles all over the place. They went fishing down off the dock. So this is very memorable to them.
Weiss became so fascinated with the history that he founded the website awixacastle.com about the home and has a strong respect for the history of the Bayshore area. Awixa Castle is currently up for sale and awaiting its new owners to continue the story of this historic house.
I think our history is something very important to be preserved. And when you walk into some of these old houses and you see the things that have been covered over with woods and painted over white, and it's my first, you know, draw is to, you know, strip the paint off, take the covers off, get rid of that carpet and the underlayment and the luan, and you know, see what everything looked like and go back. And I don't think that it's that unusual. I think a lot of people are doing that today, compared to in the 60s, I think, when everybody took a white paint can and just painted everything until it disappeared. This is a special house. It has a lot of incredible memories, and it just stood up to a direct hit from Hurricane Sandy without even taking on any water. It's a special house, and it's for special people, and you know, we're hoping that whoever buys it now will enjoy it as much as we do.
For more information, check out awixacastle.com. In Bayshore, Chris Collora reporting, Long Island Online News.